So one more chapter, that is exponents. First try to understand the concept. I write 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. I write 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. I write A into A into A. So 2 is given 4 times, so it is 2 to the power 4. 3 is given 4 times, so it is 3 to the power 4. A is in 3 times, so that's why A is 2 to the power 3. So this is the exponential part. Exponential part. Suppose if I take one more, 4 by 3 into 4 by 3 into 4 by 3. So that means it is 4 by 3 to the power 3. So this is also an exponential part. Clear? Suppose I write again 7 into 7 into 7 into 7 into 7. It is 5 times, so 7 to the power 5. Okay? These two, 3, this A, this 4 by 3, this 7 is known as base. And this 2 to the power 4, 2 to the power 4, 2 to the power 3, 2 to the power 3, 2 to the power 5 is known as power or index. Okay, so that means if I write A to the power n, so that means A is base and n is index. Okay, A is base and A is index. This index inform how many times you multiply, and this base inform what is the number you multiply. Okay, that means if I say again 3 to the power 4, so that means 3 is the base and 4 is the index. This 4 inform how many times it will multiply. So 4 times, and base inform the number you multiply. So 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Base 3 is multiplied by 4 times. 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. So that means A is the base and this M is the index. Okay? Now some rules. Rules. First one. A to the power M into A to the power n is equal to A to the power n plus n. This is known as product rule. A to the power n into A to the power n is A to the power n plus n. That means it is given 4 to the power 3 into 4 to the power 2, so it is 4 to the power 3 plus 2, that is 4 to the power 5. If base are same, then the powers are added. The index are add. Here 4 and 4 same base. There is no matter the index are different, no matter. Bases are same. Bases are same, and as it is in a multiplication, that means we add the power. One more example you take. Suppose 3 to the power 2 into 3 to the power 4 into 3 to the power 3. Bases are same, that's why I add. So 2 plus 4 plus 3, that is 3 to the power 9. Okay? 4 by 3 to the power 2 into again 4 by 3 to the power minus 2. Not like now minus 2. I take plus 3. Same thing. So what happened? Base are same. 4 by 3. and 2 plus 3, that is 4 by 3 to the power 5. That means if base are same, powers are added. Power add when bases are same in a multiplication part. So, your question, sir, if bases are not same, like this, 2 to the power 3 into 3 to the power 2, so there is no rule. You just write 2 3 times and 3 2 times. Multiply 2 to the 4 to the 8 and 3 to the 9. 8 9 is 72. Then there is no rules. If bases are same, then there is a rule. You have to add. Okay? Now second, it is known as quotient rule. If a to the power m is divided by a to the power n, then the powers are subtracted. A to the power m minus n. Divide means by or divide sign. Suppose it is given 5 to the power 4 divide 5 to the power 3. So base are same and it is in divide. So index or powers subtract. So 4 minus 3, that is 5 to the power 1, that is 5. One more example you take. 5 by 3 to the power 7 divided by 5 by 3 to the power 4. Base are same. Have to check only if base are same, then you follow the rule. So bases are equal. Bases are equal. So you follow the rule. So what happened?
Wait, my microphone is not this. Okay, now.
So it is 5 by 3 to the power 7 minus 4. That is 5 by 3 to the power 3. So that means in divide, we subtract. In multiply, we add. When bases are same. Or the rules always depend upon what? All in same basis. Rules are in same basis. If they are different base, then you do. Another thing, suppose it is given 3 to the power 5, divide sign 2 to the power 3. So what happened? 3 you write 5 times. Divide by 2 you write 3 times. Multiply. If you cut, okay, otherwise. Divide and find the answer. So if there is different base, then no rules are there. You have to simplify. If same base, then we go some rules in a shortcut way. So in same base, if it is a divide, then we subtract. In same base, it is a multiply, then we add. Clear? Now third one. That is power law. A to the power m to the power n is equal to a to the power m into n. That means suppose it is given 4 to the power 2 again to the power 3. So you write 4 to the power 2 into 3, that is 4 to the power 6. Given 1 by 3 to the power 2 again to the power 3. So you write 1 by 3 to the power 2 into 3. That is 1 by 3 to the power 6. Clear? Suppose it's given 5 minus 3 to the power 2 again to the power 5. So you write minus 5 by 3 2 into 5. That is minus 5 by 3 to the power 10. So this is power law. Clear? Now, this is not rule, we can turn it, we can transfer, you can convert. If it is given 1 by a to the power 4, a to the power m, 1 by a to the power m, so we can say it a to the power minus m and convert it also. If a to the power minus m is given, then we can change it 1 by a to the power m. That means if it is given like this, 4 to the power minus 3. So we can change it 4, the denominator is 1. 4 means denominator is 1. 1 is high there.
So you just reciprocal 1 by 4 and it has become plus 3. Okay, if it is given 2 by 3 minus 3, so you change it 3 by 2, then it has become plus 3. Okay, if it is given 1 by 2 to the power 4, you can say 2 to the power minus 4. If it is given 1 by 5 to the power 3, you can say 5 to the power minus 3. Clear? So this is some rule. If it is given 5 by 7 to the power minus 4, you say 7 by 5, just convert 7 by 5 plus 4. Okay. And one more important, that is a to the power 0 is equal to 1. A to the power 0 is equal to 1. That means anything to the power 0 is equal to 1. 5 to the power 0 is equal to 1. 105 to the power 0 is equal to 1. 2222 to the power 0 is equal to 1. A to the power is equal to 1. K to the power 0 is equal to 1. Anything. 1 by 3 to the power 0 is equal to 1. 5 by 7 to the power 0 is equal to 1. Anything to the power 0 minus 7 to the power 0 minus 7 to the power 0 is equal to 1. Anything to the power 0 is equal to 1. So these are the rules and information about exponents. Now you can solve your exercise question.